I'm Sandeep Khosla.
And I'm Abu Jani. Welcome to our show.
Our guest this evening has followed in her mother's footsteps and is an interior decorator to the stars. She's a yummy mummy with two beautiful sons. To top it all, she happens to be married to the country's hugest heartthrob. She's sweeter than candy and more beautiful than most of her husband's heroines. Please welcome the first lady in Hrithik Roshan's life, Suzanne Roshan.
Thank you for being on our show.
Thank you for calling me.
So tell me, what is it like to be the wife of the hottest man in the country?
Okay. it's really fun to know that, you know, the man that I fell in love with has become the hottest man in the country. And it's like this great a relationship that we share, even though we've been married a long time.
A long time meaning?
Yes. Like 9 years. Yeah.
Yes, okay.
But
never insecure?
Not really, never. Unfortunately, he's never given me a reason to be.
We've known you since you were that small.
Yeah, you know? I know.
And we know Suzanne, that gorgeous girl, you know.
Always shy. I was very shy. And so was he. So first, when we first met, it was really like, you know, we connected as on a certain level, because I think it was instant chemistry. But
did you meet at a traffic signal? Is it
yeah.
True?
Once when we both were at the traffic signal, car to car, and we both like looked at each other, and I just recognized him, and he knew who I was, and it was like instant something happened. I don't know what, and we both pretended that we didn't notice each other, and we went forward, and then through the rear view mirror, I was like looking at him, and then when my car went, when his car went in the front, I believe he told me that he was looking at me.
How did he woo you? I heard there was some poetry that was involved.
I don't know. It was just that he's always been very artistic and passionate about everything he does. So, like, writing poetry was something that just came naturally.
So that was
so
the
I
romance.
Think that, so when we met, it was like, it was really, you know, like what you read in books, like in fairy tales. But it's over the years of being together that you actually know what love is.
And what about the passion part now?
No, it's just no. It's like I'm saying, it just kind of like goes from the relationship that we share is just like from friendship to, you know, being husband and wife. But husband and wife, we never really took that as seriously as, you know, like there is a commitment and you got to do this. It was all about being boyfriend and girlfriend. And I think somewhere we both take each other's good and bad, and we make music out of the good and bad.
Even utensils, yeah. Crashing is,
yeah,
is music.
It's all, yeah, fun. Everything is fun. In love and war.
In love and war. Are you his biggest critic also?
When I first met him, I wasn't. I was really more like sugarcoating what I wanted to tell him, because I think I didn't share the relationship that I share with him today. So yeah, I was scared to hurt him. And I never was completely honest. Now I can just completely be blatantly, you know, brutally honest with him about anything and everything. And I feel that that is a very important thing for a couple.
Hrithik is the most successful star of his generation. Yet he's never called a number one. Does it affect you in any way?
Hrithik is not about being in a rat race, about being number one or the biggest or that. He is about being in competition with himself. He always thinks that I have to better myself. I have to better my last. His work is so important to him that I think that all these things about who's being written about and who's being portrayed as what, it's just a matter of...
You know, my one thought after watching Hrithik in Dhoom 2 was that he's the only actor, Indian actor, who I can say can be the next James Bond. Do you agree with me or no?
I mean, this is something really funny, yeah, because, I mean, we have this thing. I've been watching James Bond movies since, I don't know how many years. And since I've always told him, since, like, I met him, I was like, you know, one day I think you should be the next James Bond. So he's like, I can never be James Bond because James Bond is British, so...
But we have to have a theory. You can have an Indian mother and... A foreign father, why not?
I know. So it's just like we've always discussed this. But you know, in the end, it's like everything that happens will happen in its course of time. You know?
I've got three really simple questions for you.
Yeah.
Now, really,
we'll uncover
the dynamics of your relationships with that.
Okay.
It's hooked, booked, and cooked.
Ah.
Who said koi mil gaya?
I think him.
And who booked Kaho Na Pyar Hai?
It was both of us. It wasn't just one person.
And now who is being cooked?
He's being cooked. No. I think that we both have hooked, booked, cooked together. So I think everything has been a kind of combination of both of us.
Shared everything.
Yeah. We like to just discuss and get each other's opinion and, you know, have fun with that. So, yeah. I'm still like a little shaky and speechless. I don't know how to react and... I'm in shock.